Fresh FM.
The time is 1 o'clock. Good afternoon. This is a global update on Fresh 105.9 FM Ibadan. I am Olufemi Oluwajobi. First, the headlines. Federal government recruits 7,500 graduates as tax advocates. Court adjourns El Zakzaki's hearing to June 30th, 2017. Business CBN to mop up 200 billion naira from circulation as naira stabilizes at 364 naira per dollar. On the foreign scene, London police rules out possibility of identifying fire victims. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence hires lawyer for Russian inquiries, and in entertainment, veteran actor Patrick Doyle frowns at Davido's hit song, If. In sports, Cameroon to battle Chile to win Confederation Cup on Sunday. Stay tuned for the details of this and more. The federal government is targeting an increase in the number of taxpayers in the next 2 years from the current 14 million to 17 million. The Minister of Finance, Mrs. Kemi Adeosun, disclosed this during a media briefing yesterday in Abuja on a new initiative to drive tax revenue. Adeosun was accompanied by the Executive Chairman, Federal Inland Revenue Service, Mr. Babatunde Fowler, and other top officials in the ministry. Specifically, she said the federal government was planning to achieve the objective by recruiting 7,500 graduates as community tax liaison officers to raise the level of tax awareness in the country.
A lot of people do not know the rules, they do not know the regulations, they do not know what they should do, they do not know how to get registered, as well as those who don't want to pay. We have a solution for those who don't want to pay, but we think one of the priorities is to get more people enrolled, more people informed about their obligations under the tax system. And all the state governors, the state boards of internal revenue service are part of this program. It's really very important for the nation. If we want to reduce our dependence on oil and FAC, we have to make sure that everybody who is economically active pays.
Three bills seeking to boost the oil industry in Nigeria have scaled through second reading at the House of Representatives. The bills, which covers governance, the protection of host communities, and the regulatory framework of the oil industry, will resolve the issues that have undermined its growth. The bills enjoyed favorable reactions from members, but there was a moment of trial when the minority leader raised a point of order on the composition of the bill. After scaling through the second reading, the House referred the bill to an ad hoc committee on PIB for further legislative action.
Look at Bill 3, Bill 4, Bill 5. Yeah. They all deal on the same subject matter. And I remember vividly that these three bills, like you said, we're all consolidated. More than one bill on the same subject matter may be introduced, but when the second reading of a bill has been agreed to or negative, the question shall not be proposed for the second reading of another bill of the same subject matter during the same section. On the day relating to the bill being read, the speaker shall direct that the bill be drawn.
There's a reason that informed that decision, and we can see that progress has been made. It's not the case that we're waiting for Senate to pass and then we'll tack behind. There were issues that made us to wait until this time before we commence debate on the PIB. So that's the agreement that will address the government issues separately, address the fiscals and other issues separately.
A federal high court sitting in Kaduna has adjourned the hearing of the case filed by the leader of the Islamic movement in Nigeria against the Nigerian army and three others. In the suit, the Shiite, through their lawyer, Femi Falana SAN, are demanding 2 billion naira's compensation for the invasion and destruction of El Zakzaki's houses, the killing of his three sons, and other members of the Islamic movement by the Nigerian army, which is say amounts to the violation of his fundamental human rights. But at the resumed sitting on the matter yesterday, hearing on the suit could not go on because lawyers to the first, second, third and fourth defendants in the suit had filed an objection, describing the suit as an abuse of court process since the applicant had earlier filed a similar suit at the court of same jurisdiction in Abuja. In his ruling, Justice Shoaibu informed both parties that all their objections will be heard on the next adjourned date, 30th June 2017.
Are they going to keep him for 4 years or 10? You can't detain anybody and say you are helping him unless he's dangerous health-wise to the society. Let's say somebody has Ebola. Oh, yes. You can say let's quarantine him or her. But you can't say somebody is being detained because you fear that he may be attacked. You are supposed to protect him from the would-be attackers.
The substantive counsel actually undertook a trip for medical review and shortly returned. And now the fight is still recuperating. And to that effect, it's not that he's holding everybody for ransom, but for the matter on platter of fair hearing, everybody have to be heard substantially.
And now in business, the Central Bank of Nigeria has said that it will issue special treasury bills today to mop up 200 billion naira at the rate of 16% per annum from the banking system in order to further rein in inflation. Meanwhile, the naira remains stable at 364 naira per dollar on the parallel market. Acting Director, Corporate Communications Department, Mr. Isaac Okorafo, who disclosed this yesterday, explained that the Apex Bank decided on the rate of 16% per annum due to the falling rate of inflation, which he noted will continue to fall. You've been listening to a Global Update on Fresh 105.9 FM Ibadan. Still to come on the foreign scene, London police rules out the possibility of identifying 5 victims. Australia announces national gun amnesty. And in sport, Cameroon to battle Chile to win Confederation Cup on Sunday. Stay with Fresh 105.9 FM. Welcome back. It's National News reaching you from Fresh 105.9 FM Ibadan. You can be part of Fresh FM online community by downloading the Fresh FM Nigeria app to send us eyewitness reports using the iReport feature on the application. Simply go to Google Play Store, App Store to download the application, which gives you an interactive media experience through radio reporter feature, notification feature, and flashbulb feature. With these features, you can be a radio reporter by sending pictures, audio, text, and videos straight from your phone or tablet to our newsroom. Fresh FM Nigeria apps allows you to receive information about latest news and programs directly from Fresh FM Ibadan. And now on the foreign scene, police have warned that they may never be able to identify all the people who died in the fire that engulfed the West London block of flats. Emergency services are to spend a third day searching for bodies in the burnt-out Greenfell Tower in North Kensington. 17 people are known to have died, but the figure is said to rise with fears. The death toll could exceed 60. Fire chiefs said they do not expect to find more survivors, while Prime Minister Theresa May has ordered a full public inquiry. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence has hired an outside lawyer, Richard Cullen, to handle his response to inquiries into possible ties between President Donald Trump's campaign and Russia. The decision is to hire Cullen was announced yesterday by Pence's office, saying the vice president had earlier interviewed several candidates. Pence's spokesman, Jared Egan, however, said the vice president is focused entirely on his duties promoting the president's agenda as he looks forward to a swift conclusion of this matter. Recall that U.S. media had earlier reported that Donald Trump was being investigated by special counsel Robert Mueller for possible obstruction of justice. Australia is bringing in its first national gun amnesty since 1996 because of the growing terrorism threat and an influx of illegal arms in the country. During the three-month amnesty running from 1st of July, people can hand in unregistered weapons without the fear of prosecution. Those caught outside that period faces fines of up to $212,730. Justice Minister Michael Keenan is expected to announce the further details of the government initiative later today. An explosion at the gates of a Chinese kindergarten that killed 8 people was caused by a 22-year-old man who died in the blast. Bomb-making materials were found in a flat where the man named as Su lived, and the words "die and death" had been scribbled on the walls. The blast, however, happened just as parents in Fengxian in the eastern province of Jiangsu were picking up their children at the end of the day. More than 60 people were injured in the explosion, including 8 who are in serious condition. And now in entertainment, a veteran actor and ace broadcaster Patrick Doyle has frowned at the Davido's 8th song, If, which is currently rolling the airwaves, saying the song is causing a serious harm to the Nigerian youth. The entertainer, while speaking about entertainment and their impact on Nigerian youth, the veteran actor faulted Davido's $30 billion slogan from his If song. According to him, most people don't understand that money doesn't come easily and might do anything just to get such money after listening to the song.
Entertainment and pop culture impact the people in a very, very subtle, but for want of a better word, insidious manner. We get our mannerisms. Have you beginning to hear 30 billion for our account to... It just, and that's from entertainment. And when you start telling a young child that 30 billion for our account to, you know, he's singing it, but that he's going to grow up wanting to get 30 billion by any means necessary.
And now talking sports. African champions Cameroon will begin their quest to be the first team from the continent to win the Confederation Cup when they tackle Chile on Sunday. Cameroon, making a comeback 14 years later, will participate for the third time in its history of the competition. It was in 2003 that the Indomitable Lions gave their best performance by reaching the final against France. Before we end the global update, here is the recap of the main stories. Federal government to recruit 7,500 graduates as tax advocates. Quote, as adjourned El Zakzaki's hearing till June 30, 2017. In business, CBN to mop up 200 billion naira from circulation as naira stabilizes at 364 naira per dollar. On the foreign scene, London Police has ruled out possibility of identifying fire victims. Australia has announced a national gun amnesty. And in entertainment, veteran actor Patrick Doyle has frowned at Davido's hit song, If. In sports, Cameroon to battle Chile to win Confederation Cup on Sunday. That's the global update and Fresh 105.9 FM Ibadan. The news was packed by Victoria David and edited by Samson Akindele. I am Olufemi Oluwajobi. Thanking you for joining us. Good afternoon.
Fresh.
Abisi mo ni koye toju bole mo kini wa tawon mo lo se ninu yara landlord o fe gboran abi
ah ah e ma binu se femi na si so fe pe ke so wo sori decoder